Oh my god. I wasn't prepared for this today. Alright you guys, today we're gonna be checking out Scam Season 2, Episode 12. This is the finale, and this one is called Do You Want to Move In With Me? I'm not prepared for this, I think that's safe to say. This season has been phenomenal, the best season of the show. Well, I've only seen two, but Season 1 was great. Like, of course, it got me into the show. It made me stay with it, so it clearly made me love the show. But Season 2 was phenomenal. It was like, it felt like so much longer, like there was so much more packed into it. It felt like such a more packed story, and it was just amazing. I loved every second of it, and this has literally become one of my favorite shows. Like, I'm not even joking, like in the top five. And I've watched a lot of shows, people. A lot of shows. And this has just been so, it's just been so much fun for me. And like, I keep, like, I'm literally, like, half the time I'm on Instagram, I'm watching edits of this show because I can't keep, I can't help myself. And I try to stay away from spoilers, and I can't, it's hard. Anyways, yeah, and I'm glad we only are halfway through. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, though, I know there's still, like, two seasons of the show, and I'm super excited for Season 3. Isaac, I have missed him so much. He literally has not been in the season at all. I'm hyped for his season, but I'm gonna miss William and Nora a lot. Like, I know they're gonna still be in it, but come on. Like, I know I'm really not gonna get that much William in Season 3. Like, I know it, and I'm so sad about that, because he's my favorite character as of now. Him and Nora are my favorite character, but my two favorite characters as of right now, and I'm not ready to let them go, but I'm gonna have to. Anyways, yeah, if you guys want to watch my full uncut reaction to this episode, oh god, I don't know how I'm gonna put this on YouTube, because this is so long, and I'm gonna talk so much. This is either going to be really short on YouTube or in two parts. I don't know if this is like, if it says part one in the title, part two is in the description. Either way, if you guys want to check out the full reaction, the full uncut reaction, you guys get all my commentary beginning to end. No pauses, no cuts. It's just, you get to see every scene, all my reactions to every scene, all my comments, anything I say, you guys get the whole thing. And that will be on Patreon in tier 4 and above for you guys. And also, all of Season 3 will be on there as well. Like I've done since the show started. So you will, like, right now, if this is on YouTube, you could probably watch up to episode 303 right now on Patreon. The Season 3 trailer will be up there right now. Season 3 premiere will be up there right now. Season 302 will be up there right now. And probably Season 303 will be up there right now if this is up on YouTube. That will be up on there in for all Patrons in tier 1 and above. So that's just a dollar. And yeah, that is all in the description, along with all the full uncut reactions. So if you guys want that, check it out. And yeah, also check out my Twitter, follow me. And without further ado, I am beyond excited. All right, folks, let's do this. Let's go. Scam Season 2 finale. Oh, look at them! They're cuddling. Dude, they're adorable. Is it bad? Like, I kind of just want to jump in there. Is that weird? Leave me out free. Oh, look how small she is next to him! She's definitely the little spoon. Oh. Okay, wait. I'm gonna cry. Oh my. Oh, she's saying why she's so insecure about it. Is that the only sex experience she had, though? I assume so.
So, them born.
Sorry, guys. I'm really stuffed up. Allergy season.
Så ble jeg ganske sjuk.
You're talking about the food thing? You're talking about an eating disorder?
Så jeg vil bare...
I'm sorry, I'm...
Jeg er redd for at... det skal skje noe sånt igjen.
No, sweetie, he would never hurt you. We know that. Look at him. That is love in his eyes. Can you see that?
Yeah.
I see it. It's love.
Hi. I have little Emma.
Aww.
Friendly quotes.
Okay, finally, we're talking about this. This place is nice as fuck!
You doubt yourself there, Mr. Tunnel.
You scared you're gonna, like, do something bad? Are you scared he's gonna do something bad? I don't get it. Is he scared of himself, or is he scared of Nico? How? I just want to know where he's getting the money. How does everyone... I just want to know. How do these people afford to live? Okay. Eva. Her mom probably sends her money for groceries and stuff because her mom's never there. Isaac and Jonas seem to live with their parents. William is apparently a 25-year-old man. I don't know how the hell he pays for anything. He doesn't work. He's disconnected from his parents. Nora. Do they send her checks or something? Because she doesn't work either. Listen, I just don't... It's a logic flaw. Where do they get the money? How's he just gonna buy a new apartment? Do you think... Bro, I wanna buy an apartment. I can't yet.
That would have been a day.
Yeah. Asking the real questions over here. Ask her to move in with you. Ask her. He wants to. I knew it! I mean, it's the title of the episode. Come on! Say yes! Why not? You're already living with your roommates. Imagine living with him. It would be amazing. She's gonna say yes. Say yes! Yeah!
Okay.
Yes! Oh my god, I can't believe this. Living together in high school? Yeah! Oh, this is adorable! I fucking love that. They haven't even had sex yet. That's how you know it's love! The first fuck is gonna be in there. Oh my god, I gotta stop swearing. I probably get the worst ads. Ugh. Oh. Oh! Oh my. Oh! Oh, they're doing it. Oh, they're gonna have sex right on that counter. They're gonna do it right on that counter. He's been waiting for this for... Oh my god. Oh, I've been waiting for this. This is so hot. Oh my god. Don't stop. She wants it. Don't ruin this with the bills. Oh my god. Does that say his name on it? Dude, they're just about to have sex. These bills, what a cock block. Oh my god, is it the bottle thing? Oh my god. I knew this would come back. Jesus fucking Christ. Oh my god. Fuck. Oh my god, dude, it's the last. We have 30 minutes left of this season. Can we please not end it in troubles? I want a nice end to the season. I want happiness. Can they just go apartment hunting? That's all I want to see for the next 30 minutes. Apartment hunting. This music is... Well, it's not really fitting the situation, but... You know what, Nora? One day, I'm gonna hug you.
Escape.
It's just gonna happen. Probably one of his men.
Men, det må bare, det må ta slutt, okay? Fordi liksom vi har begynt å få naboklager fra.
I'm gonna miss the fuck out of this season. God, I'm so happy I have two more though. Oh. Don't know why I'm saying it. He's just snooping around your room.
No, I'm but
maybe.
Kanske du kunde ringa.
And talk? Oh my god, she wants to try things her way. I see.
Hvorfor skal jeg det?
Because she wants you to try her way.
Du kunne spurt han om han ikke kunne si noe.
She wants to be mature, maybe.
I det avhøret, vet du.
She's right, though. Okay, let's be real. Let's think about it. She's right. Like, if he handles this maturely, like, if he just calls calmly and is like, listen, buddy, I'm sorry. You gotta understand. You hurt my friends for no reason. What did you, like, why, how is it fair that I get in trouble for defending my friends and you guys have beat up multiple people for no reason and you don't get in trouble? Like, think about how that's fair. Like, they gotta talk about it. And I think her way could work. Just saying. Gotta read. Hi, you don't know me, but I was there during the fight on the 29th of April, and I just wanted to say that none of the riot guys or anyone else who was there will say anything about what happened as long as you guys don't say anything. Smart girl. Oh my god! I knew it. I was gonna say, like, oh, he's gonna confess. But I didn't say it because I'm like, I don't wanna jinx it. Maybe he didn't. Oh. Dude, they weren't gonna say anything. They weren't gonna say anything. You just ruined it. You put yourself in jail for 6 months. I gotta go to the bathroom. That made me nervous. Oh, I'm back. Okay. Here we go.
Det at vi skulle tro på...
Leave in and trust.
Vi stole på det, at vi har et rettferdig rettssystem. Så bare valgte jeg å stole på det.
Oh, now you trust that? I mean, cute, but...
Kunne jeg valgt å ikke stole på det? Og så heller bare holdt kjeft om det. Men da måtte jeg nesten ha drømt det. Hvis du skjønner.
Yeah, he's going by his little code here. He's the type of dude that, like, if he says one thing, like, he's gonna, like, stay to that. He's not gonna, like, pick and choose the situation, like, what he... Like, do you know what I mean? Like, he's not gonna pick and choose, like, oh, it's okay to do this in this situation, but in this situation, it's okay to do this because it helps me. Like, you know what I mean? Like, if he believes in one thing, he's gonna just... Like, he knows you didn't have bad intentions with that bottle thing. Like, he didn't want to kill him. It was self-defense... Or not self-defense, but he was defending, like, doing the right thing. He had it coming, the guy, so he's like, if the system is fair, like, I won't get in trouble, he'll get in trouble, because they beat up everyone for no reason. What did he do? Probably, the dude's probably fine, you know what I mean? I get what he's saying. She's seeing such a change in him. This is adorable. Come on, don't tell me his character development wasn't amazing. He had the best character development. I don't understand how you guys, like, I mean, okay, I understand how people don't like him. But I also don't. Like, it makes no sense to me. He's like, a way better guy than when he first came in. Like, yeah, I didn't like him at the beginning, but now... I mean... Ah! Go reclaim that apartment! I mean, might as well. You got nothing to lose now.
Yeah.
Oh! I got a feeling! Oh my god, they picked the best music. I got a feeling, ooh, that tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's gonna be a good night. That was a little bit ahead of that one. Ooh, that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. Oh, okay. I don't remember the song. Good night. Oh, this is so cool! I forgot they had like a little fucking roof or something here. What is this? Yeah, same. Me and him have the same dance moves. It's just the head bopping. Conversing time. OK, Okay, but where's Isaac? That's what I want. Whoa! He got a haircut! Wait, I'm not okay. Who let him do that? Look at this bitch. I mean, he looked good. But I wasn't ready for the hair to go. He'll grow back. I just wasn't ready. Oh my god, he looks like a he just looks so cute now. Oh, bless him. Look at him. I've missed you. Oh, getting those vibes.
Hi.
Whoa, that was weird. I'm gonna rewatch that. Oh! You guys don't think I'm catching on right now? See the way they looked at each other? That was a fake first meeting. They know each other. You think I don't know? Now I know. Oh my god! Is Isaac living in the basement? Wait. Wait! Hey! He didn't give us a proper answer. He just said it was that Nico guy. He said it was that Nico guy. Maybe that was because that was because she thought that, and he's like, oh, that's a good cover. Oh, yeah, we'll go with that. And next season is Isaac's season. We have to set something up for him. Oh, I know it's him. I know he's been in the basement. I know. Oh, I fucking know. He's exploring his sexuality, and he loves it. I know. Oh, look. Okay. Okay, all right, okay. Listen, I have not seen my boys in a minute. Look how good they look. Look how good Isaac and Jonas look. Do you see that? First of all, Jonas grew the fuck up. This boy's got a fresh haircut, looking good. Isaac, looking clean as fuck, looking like a little cutie. They both dress nice as hell too. Oh my god. Oh, I just know Isaac is about to go into his prime right before his season starts. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. We're not ready for this, folks. Hey! She's so cute. They're the... Oh my gosh, she's adorable. I literally... Oh my god, wait. If I ever see him smile like that again, I'm gonna have a heart explosion. Look at that smile. He is gorgeous. She doesn't want to go there and chill. She wants to go there and have fun. Already know I wanna fuck you. Oh, okay. You already know I wanna fuck you. You already know. Oh! He wants to fuck her. Oh.
Yes, yes.
Oh, Chris. He needs that bed for them. Bye! Reserved for them! Oh my fucking god. Oh my god. Oh! She's ready, trust me! Oh! I've been waiting for this the whole season. This season was pretty much one big lead up to them having sex. That's it. Oh, oh my god. Oh my god, shirt's off. Oh my god. I don't know if I'm allowed to look at this. Am I allowed to look at this? Oh, his shirt's off. Okay. I'm looking. This is, like, beautiful. Because they've waited so long. Oh! Oh, Santa! She's so cute. Looking like a sunflower. Oh! Casper from the cabin! What the fuck? Why is he? This is so weird. This is weird. Oh! She's being sexy. Okay, okay. I can't. Yes, I can.
That's not
He's the life of the party. I love him. Dude, he's one of the best parts of the season.
Isaac, you look so good! Oh my god. He just... Wow. Puberty did something to him. Puberty did something to him. Let me tell you that. I have been waiting for this. Not to sound like a creep, but I've been waiting for this forever. I'm a creep. Oh, wow. They did it. They really did that, huh? Oh, he... I wonder if they used a condom. Better be safe than sorry. Nah, he looks like his pillow game is strong. I cannot believe that. I love this.
Jeg tror jeg har gjort noe dumt. Jeg sendte en melding til han jeg kjuset på.
Oh, fuck, fuck, fuck. He's so cute.
Jeg visste du kom til
å gjøre. Jeg er ikke sur.
Nah, he loves you. You're just looking out for each other. Aw, I love when he does that to her nose. Dude, oh, there's only like a few minutes left. I hate, this cannot be over. Oh, I'm going through depression right now. No, I'm not ready for this time. Stop. Stop ending. New roommate. Fuck. Oh. Isaac, oh, cause he's already living in the basement. Yeah, he's stepped up his game. The what? All right, guys, that was the Scam season 2 finale. We're done season 2. Oh my god. See, oh, that was the best thing I've ever experienced in my life. That whole season. That was beautiful. All right, let's talk about that real quick. Of course, you guys know when we have big episodes, I gotta move up here to do my review because I just gotta be comfier. And that was next. That was. It's so weird for me to say that the season's over. I can't believe that this season is complete. This season, when I think about Scam, like I think about season 2 now. Like it was so different from season 1, and I feel like this season is really what kept me grounded to the show. Like season 1 was great, I liked it, it kept me going. Season 2 was like a whole different experience. Season 2 was like, it was flawless. Like this season was phenomenal. I have zero complaints about the season. It was so much fun. It had such great development for so many characters actually. Vilda, Nora, William, especially William. Like it included so much, and I know this that each season is focused on a certain character, but I feel like this season is probably going to be the one season where it wasn't just them. Like there was so much. Like Vilda was in the season so much. She went through so much. You know, we got so much of her character. We saw a little bit of Eva too. Like we got so much of the season. This felt like a really well-rounded and balanced season. Like yes, the main focus is Nora and William, but it was just so, they went through so much content, and I loved every second of it. I think they just did such a great job. Now, we're going to talk a little bit about the season as a whole later, but right now, I just want to cover this episode particularly. So, after the events of last episode, Nora and William, they were fighting, there was a really big miscommunication, but whatever, William looked past it, they got back together. In a very happy way, you know, running into each other's arms, kissing, all that. This episode, they wake up in bed, they just spend a day in bed, beautiful. Spend a day in bed, relax, just running a lazy day. Spend a lazy day together, I get that, it was beautiful. Loved that, like, just seeing them cuddle and be so cute. And again, this is something I talked about last episode, but the fact that there was just like a 2-minute scene of them not talking at all, just silence. And, you know, it's music, whatever. And them sitting there just cuddling and, like, being so soft and being so loving and affectionate. That is what I love about the show. It is so descriptive in the in the production of the show, like the way it's shot, like everything is just so descriptive without words. It's very realistic in my opinion. Like everything about this is like, yeah, like in real life, there would be these long silences. Like, not people aren't talking all the time. Like, this is like how people act. Like it's just how it is. And like, sure, not everything's super realistic, but just the scenario and how it is shot, I think, is very realistic. And I love that idea of it. I love the realism in the show. And so yeah, they have some time in bed. It's all cute. And basically, the big thing you want to take away from this episode is, I think the thing with this episode is it came to a conclusion that was like, it wasn't really, like, it was a conclusion, but it wasn't really a conclusion. Like, we didn't actually get to see the ending of what happened. Like, we didn't get to see the outcome of, like, everything that was going on. It was kind of just, like, I feel like the characters were in, like, their final forms in terms of, like, their development and stuff with the season. Like, not, it's weird to explain. So, okay, let's just go through. So, like, they're laying in bed, whatever, that thing, whole thing happens, and then it comes to just William and Nora talking about Nico, and Nora actually explains everything about, like, she had sex when she was 13. She explains, like, why everything's so hard for her, like, she got sick, like, all this stuff, and she was, you know, self-conscious about that. And William obviously respects that. William knows, like, we have to keep in mind, they haven't had sex yet. They've been together all this time. We know they're so in love, and they haven't even had sex yet. That is how you know they're in love. So I think you have to keep that in mind throughout this whole season. Is like, it makes it all so much more sweet that they haven't had sex yet. So the only thing tethering them together is the way they feel about each other and all that. I thought that was beautiful. So you have her telling him all that, him just kind of, like, accepting it and showing her that, you know, I respect you, you know, I'm not gonna go push any further, like, we're gonna go at your pace, whatever. So he doesn't, like, he tries to kind of keep his distance. You see throughout the episode, he's kind of just holding himself back, because he does want to, like, I mean, who wouldn't? Look at her. He wants to have sex with her, like, he's a guy, we get it. But obviously, he's gonna respect that, so, anyways, that happens. They get to talking about Nico. He said he doesn't want to face him, like, all this stuff. Nico's disappeared, so, the only thing that's a little bit weird is, like, Nico disappeared. We didn't get to see any conclusion with Nico. He's just gone. The bitch is gone. He fled the scene. I don't know if they did end up reporting him or they're planning on doing it. I don't know what's going to happen there. But basically, he didn't want to face him. Long story short, William asks Eve, not Eve, oh my god. William asks Nora to move in with him, which was amazing. It was so cute because it's just like, I feel like it's just right. Like, they both basically live alone. Why not live with each other? Like, I don't know how the fuck Eskild and Lynn are gonna survive without Nora, but either way, like, the whole thing is just so, like, I just felt like, yeah, like, come on, like, they might as well move in together. They have all this money somehow, I don't know how, but, I mean, I just thought that was beautiful. I wish we got to actually see them move in together. Maybe we'll see a little bit of that next season, I don't know. But anyways, he ended up getting a letter saying that he was getting questioned. Basically, the cops are, like, questioning him about the bottle thing, all this stuff. He's at risk of going to jail for 6 fucking months. Nora suggests, like, oh, come on, talk it out, talk to him, whatever. Like talk to the guy, like, they won't say anything, just try to talk it out. And he says no, so they're on 2 completely different pages right now. He doesn't want to talk, he just wants to, like, he's too full of pride. She wants him to talk, she doesn't want him to go to jail, like, she does not want that, obviously, like, who wants that? Anyways, he ends up going to get questioned. He confesses the whole thing. The thing that sucks is, while he decided to confess that, she sorted it out with the guys. They're not going to say anything, so he would have been 100% safe. But he did it because he promised her he would trust the system and have faith that it would be fair with the whole Nico thing. And he just wants to keep his word. He wants to be on the same page with everything. He's a man of his word. If he's gonna trust the system in this situation, he's gonna have to trust the system in every situation. He's that type of man. Like, he doesn't want to go back on his word and pick and choose with the situation. So, he confesses and explains his mindset behind it. And it's just kind of cute because you kind of see in that moment, you see the type of man he is. And, like, you see him kind of how far he's come and, like, being a man that respects. You see, like, he just kind of, like, he has, like, morals, like, he has his his reasons for things, and he owns up to his actions, and I really like that. Like, he owns up to his actions, and that's the great part. So basically, we don't know what's gonna happen with that right now. He could be going to jail. We don't know. He's got a few weeks before he goes to court. They decide to have a big party. Big party. Yeah. Woo. So they decide to have just a big party, just to have some fun, you know. And let me tell you something. This party setting, the party environment, the whole thing they got going on with the party there, I loved it. That's something they do so well with the show as well. Is they good at fucking picking music. The party scenes and everything directed so well. It just feel like, it feels like what a high school party would be. Like, maybe not. I don't know. I haven't been to that many. I've been to like two, and Wow. I really didn't go to high school parties, so I couldn't tell you if that's how they are. But for the most part, they just seem like the environment is very, it's done very well. It has a very cool vibe to it. I like it a lot. So the whole party thing was cool. They picked good music, good throwback music. I love that whole thing. Before I get into the Nora and William thing, Eskild and Isaac meeting, was it just me or did that seem like really fake? Like, it wasn't a real first meeting. Like, they definitely know each other. We know someone's living in Nora's basement. They need a new roommate now. Connect the dots? I think so. I think that Isaac has been exploring his sexuality. I think that he wanted the real thing. He doesn't want that porn anymore. And I think Eskild, when he found out he wasn't gay, he lied. And they've been having fun ever since. And I think that he's been in the basement. They've been doing it in the basement, having some fun. It just seemed really like, it just seemed weird. Like, why did they show Isaac meeting Eskild and not Jonas? Jonas didn't say hi to him. Convenient. And Isaac season is next, so I just think they're setting something up there. I think that's the case with that. Anyways, moving on. Nora and William, they've been dying all season. They're horny as hell. They want to have sex. They want to do it. I don't blame them. I've wanted them to have sex this whole season. Watching them has made me horny because I could see the fucking sexual tension there. They ended up doing it. They ended up having sex finally, for fuck's sake. Finally. They do it. They have sex. It is beautiful. They didn't even have to show it. I just know it was beautiful. It was great. They had sex finally, and I think that was something that was very, like full circle as well. Like the whole season, like, you've just been anticipating them having sex. And their chemistry has been so amazing this entire season. Their love, everything, like, they just seem like such a perfect couple. Like, their chemistry is beautiful. I forgot they didn't have sex. Every time I, like, throughout the season, I thought, like, oh my god, they haven't had sex yet. It just makes no sense to me because they are such a great couple. And I think this season really makes you realize that, like, it makes you appreciate what's really good in a relationship. And like, show you, like that you don't need, like, sex and everything. That doesn't make it all, like... They had such a beautiful connection without sex, and that is amazing. That's how you know it's real. So I love that whole thing. Them finally coming full circle, because she mentioned it's been something from the beginning. They've been teasing each other, like, I'm not gonna do it. Like, we're not gonna have sex. Come on, like they've been teasing each other. Like she's like, oh, no sex till marriage, and they finally did it. And I think it's just like full circle. Like, oh, they finally had sex. There we go. Like I feel like this whole season was them building the relationship up romantically, emotionally. And once they got to, like, their fullest state, like, their fullest potential, not even their fullest potential, because they have so much more to go, but once they got to the point where they're just completely, like, whole as a couple, they're like, okay, now it's time. And I feel like it just was a mutual thing, like, that's, they just decided to do it then, and I love that. So, love that. Also, Chris was in that room making out. It's been seeing some Chris here and there. Honestly, when I first started the show, I thought Chris would be in the show a lot more. Didn't seem to be that way. He was in it for like 5 minutes and he just was never in the show again. So, that sucks. Maybe we'll get more of him in the future. I don't know. But I'm interested in his character. I don't know. We haven't really gotten any of him though, and I doubt we will, because like there's no. Maybe him and Isaac. I'm not gonna rule that out. Not gonna rule it out, but anyways, yeah, and then they just talk about moving in and all this stuff, and that was it, and it ended. And I realized, like, I was kind of like, what? Like this season didn't really have, like, a big ending. Like, it was very at ease. The season didn't really have a shocking ending, no cliffhanger. It was just kind of, I feel like there's a next episode. Like, I just don't feel like that's the end of that season. And I think with this show, I often expect there to be, like, this big, huge ending, because I feel like every season... I have it in my head that every season, like, once season ends, like, you're done with that character story. And, like,
that's not necessarily the case. Like, they're still in the show. It's just from another character's perspective, but it seems really, like, weird. I don't know. Maybe Nora and William will be in season 3 and 4 quite a bit. Like, I'm sure Nora is gonna be in season 4 a ton. But season 3, I feel like we're gonna get a really big break from them, which is gonna suck. But I'm excited to get into a new story, always. And Isaac is one I've been waiting for forever. So, that was honestly great. Like, I thought the ending to the season was perfect. It was just so peaceful. It was just, I felt very satisfied. I didn't feel like, oh, I didn't feel like, ooh, like, oh my God, wow. Like, I just felt like, wow. Like, they did that. Like, it was just, it felt perfect. That's what it felt like. Everything was in a perfect spot. Nothing's going wrong right now. And the story's gonna continue just from a different perspective. So, I love that. This season, solid 12 out of 10. Loved it. Let me know. I wanna know in the comments right now, what did you guys think about that season? Tell me, what did you guys think about it? Was it great? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Is it your favorite season? What's your favorite season? Let me know. And also, let me know if you guys shipped William and Nora. Do you guys love William and Nora? I love them to death. They're my favorite relationship in the show, and I just don't see that changing. Unless season 3, we'll see with Isaac. but yeah, love that. Great one. If you guys want to watch the full uncut reaction to this episode, as well as the full uncut reaction to all my reactions to all the scam videos and any other videos you guys want, that'll be on Patreon at tier 4 and above for you guys. It is just the full reaction, beginning to end, no cuts. You guys can see every scene. It's just a whole lot of extra content, basically. It's just like, it's everything I have pretty much for that video. If you guys want that, that is all on Patreon in tier 4 and above. As well as if you guys just want to get my videos early, for example, you could watch probably the first few episodes of season 3. They're up there right now. I'm always a few episodes ahead on Patreon, so if you guys want to head over on there, tier 1 and above, all Patreons get the early ones. So that is just $1. That's pretty cheap. $1 a month. I'm sorry, I don't mean to shamelessly I do mean to shamelessly plug myself. I do it at the beginning, at the end of all my videos. I can't help it. I hope you guys enjoy this stuff. Anyways, yeah, guys, season 2, it's over. It's over, folks. Hope you guys enjoyed that. I had a blast this season with you guys. I had a lot of fun. Hopefully you guys had fun as well. I will see you guys very, very soon for season 3.